this is Jennifer Elster, and I am here to say hi. Hope everybody's doing okay. I know that these are really strenuous times. So hopefully you are finding some enjoyment in spite of the situation, because after all, we are very lucky to, if we have a roof over our heads and we have food and we have water and we are safe, that we're not going into the front lines with a bandana over our face and trying to save people and putting our lives and our families' lives at risk. So we're lucky and we're fortunate, and hopefully we can do everything that we can do to try to make this situation a better situation. And that's something that I've been focusing on. And you know, the thing is that I think also to realize that we're in a state of emergency, and this doesn't happen a lot. You know, nothing like this has happened in our lifetime, and we've been very lucky. So, so that's something else, just to really realize that we've been lucky. And so don't whine about being restless. No, I'm kidding. But I'm kind of not kidding, actually. Okay, so something that I would like to read to you today is a letter that I wrote to Governor Cuomo on March 19th, 2020, regarding utmost concern. COVID-19 grave reinfection must change quarantine time and extend testing period after testing negative. Dear Governor Cuomo, thank you for your courage and endurance during these challenging times. As per your address to the press, I felt it was of immediate urgency to contact you in regard to your statement allowing the woman who was infected with COVID-19 back into the workforce after she had tested negative. This would be a dangerous precedent to set, as it has been proven through recent cases that there have been relapses which have even been fatal. Whether the reoccurrence of the virus was due to a weakened immunity and secondary exposure, faulty testing, or if COVID-19 simply reoccurred is unknown. It is also true that COVID-19 has taken as long as 27 days before developing, and the virus has stayed in the system for 14 days after the virus's symptoms have ceased. What does this mean? There should be a weekly test for a four-week period after testing negative. And, you know, and then study that, see what happens, and, you know, take it from there, obviously. People should be quarantining themselves for a four-week, 28 days period to discern if they have been infected, as opposed to the 14-day quarantine recommended, or we could potentially continue to reinfect not only the patient, but our communities. Please refer to the research articles below. And then if you go to Nonpartisan Peace on channelelster.com, which I'm going to have like the link in the bio, or in the bio, I guess depending where it lives, you can see the research articles there. And I think that this is now beginning to come into the mainstream a little bit more, but we definitely need to push this, because we're just going to keep reinfecting our communities if we're not dealing with this in the proper way. And this isn't like hearsay. This is factual. These are factual situations. We just don't know enough about this virus to make any definitive resolutions about it. You know, we can't be resolved. It's something that's alive. It's changing. It's moving. And it's important to pay attention to those details. And then the other thing that I wake up very upset about is I also sent this letter to Governor Cuomo on, let's say, March 25th. And I've been trying to relay this information also in different ways. COVID-19 altered de Blasio's grab-and-go program. Under Mayor de Blasio's current grab-and-go, children under 18 can pick up their food from 400 public school buildings in New York City. This effort was a great first step, but now it must transition as it puts these children and their families at risk, as well as sustains a density in New York City on a daily basis. If a single mother gets sick, who will care for her child? An immediate revision to grab and go would be to supply for 1 week's food at pickup, which would result in families commuting less. therefore reducing density of all of these families in public spaces from 7 days down to 1 day. Then perhaps Jeff Bezos of Amazon or Jason Ackerman of Fresh Direct could configure a sign up for weekly delivery of food for children. Delivery service will further reduce the density. Thereafter, enhance our food stamps program to properly care for these children's nutrition and phase out direct delivery to allow children and their parents, caretakers, to retrieve their own food. It just completely rips me apart that all these families are going into public spaces and sharing spaces and exposing themselves to pick up meals every day when there's a different way to manage that situation, and I hope that that gets taken care of as well. So here we are, people. Just buckle up. It's about to get super rough, but we got this because we're really fortunate. And for whoever's watching this who isn't fortunate, I'm so sorry for any of the suffering and the hard times that you're going through. I know financial suffering is very difficult, but a collapsed lung and looking for your next breath is more difficult. In any case, have a great night. Have a visitor. Hey, hello. You want to say hello real quick?
Hello.
To, I don't know, the internet maybe? Just stick your head out. Let's see. Oh, it's a hand. It's a talking hand. What does the hand have to say? Does the hand have to say anything? The hand is speechless. Okay. Anyway, have a great night. Big hugs going out to everybody. Lots of love. And be aware. Be aware. Yeah, what's this? Oh, almonds. Look at that. We got almonds. We're hot stuff. We got almonds. I also included a biography of my background, which I normally don't get quite so personal about, on the nonpartisan peace page, because I would like to help out with the task force for COVID-19. I think that I can be useful in this way. I've dealt with a lot of things, so those things kind of equip you in different ways. So in any case, have a great night. Have a wonderful night. If you have somebody to hold tight, hold tight. If not, hold the FaceTime tight, or whatever one does in these strange times that we live in. Bye!